Hi, today I'm here to talk about or give you an overview of PMI Study Hall. As you know, this particular software, which is to help the student to pass the PMP exam, is prepared by PMI themselves and is sold as, in a subscription model. If you go to your dashboard, you can buy it from the products and subscription option out here. So this is the one which I bought, and I wanted to show you how the software is. This particular video talks about the overall walkthrough of the PMI Study Hall. So let's get started. When I open the PMI Study Hall, I can click on, the things which I bought. Apparently, this is not available in India right now. So I had to buy it from, so it's not available in India. When I log in, I tried and did some kind of R&D and before I wanted to reach out to you guys. So if I click on home, this is the dashboard it shows. When I first started my PMI or study hall, it asked me the total days until the exam. So here it shows how many days are there for you to prepare, the learning plan progress, which is a good thing, and then the learning task. It also talks about, your percentile rank with respect to how are other people doing it, average score on the practice, and few matrices like that. PMI also has given some kind of games. I will show you how the games are, and also some kind of badges, just to feel people happy. So these are few badges which are available for you. This won't help you in the PMP exam prep, just to amuse you. And here it kind of shows you, where exactly you are, how are you doing in some of the eco matrices. For example, I tried and clicked on stakeholders and gave a quiz, and it shows me where am I with respect to quiz. So that's pretty much the dashboard. Let's look at each button here or menu item here and see how things are. So let me click on, okay, first of all, let me click on this learning task and show you what is available. So this is the lesson 2 of the PMP. Let me go to the learning plan first. It's gonna simplify things. Learning plan is few videos wherein there are things like how is PMI, how do you prepare for the PMP exam, and so on. And then a few topics. Under that topics, there are videos and there are theories and so on. So I'm gonna pick up one topic for you and we'll review together. We have gone through the dashboard or home. Let me click on learning plan and see what comes up. In the learning plan, what comes up is few videos. Let me go through the, how do I manage conflict. There is a video of somebody talking about conflict management. And so let me play it for you so that you understand how it is.
Well, this technique within the scenario, allow me to give you a little information on my background. I have been practicing and studying project management since 2007. Over the years, I've worked under contract for several different Fortune 100. Helped in better decision making, builds greater trust within the project team. And to ensure that this happens, both sides need to be actively engaged and not depend solely on the project manager.
So I'm gonna stop here. This is one of the video. I review this video and move to the next one. This is the video here. However, this is a video which talks about, practicing project manager, how they manage conflict. what I found in this video was the techniques of how do you manage conflict from the PMBOK way was missing. And hence you have a theory lesson which talks about, you know, what are different techniques to manage conflict. These are taken from PMBOK, and this is something you need to remember. Once I go through that, I would, I don't know why you have this, but I'm gonna say, okay, my confidence level is medium. Go back, learning task. Okay, slightly confusing, so I'm gonna come back to learning plan itself and then see. I finished this, and then let's look at, you know, how do we deliver project success with cross-team collaboration. So let's see, what is it? So this is the organization, a case study, and some theory. No video, however, there is some picture. So I come back here, I might read this, I might not. So you decide as to how difficult or easy it is. So let's say I've gone through this case study. Now, conflicts in project environment, what does it do? What is conflict? So some Oxford dictionary, what is the meaning of conflict? How do you view conflict? Causes of conflict. And why conflict happens, and then forming, storming, norming, and performing. This is all about team performance. This is the Tuckman ladder, which is pretty nice. Cultural differences, I like this. So we have conflict management here. I go back to my learning plan, come back here. See, the problem with this learning plan is until unless I click submit, when I go to learning task, it's gonna keep on showing me the next learning task. And if I want to jump to a different learning task, it would not. So if I click on this, I have stopped here. So it's always gonna show me about PMP. So I need to say okay and continue, and then only it would mark this thing for me as you know, as finished. So if I go to learning plan now, it would kind of shows that yeah, I've done this. So this is one way. If you want to go sequentially, you can use a learning task, this kind of, you know, this kind of navigation. Else, if you are like me, I would click on left hand side and jump from one topic to another. So this is something which we reviewed. Let's look at project management and conflict management. This is again a theory, and then talks about, you know, various conflict which we have read earlier as well. So I'm gonna go back, and then these are the questions which I can do to see whether I understood conflict management or not. So let's do a few questions and see whether the questions me and you are able to understand conflict or not. A project manager is acting as a scrum master in hybrid project and dealing with a conflict between team members. What strategy should be used to handle conflicts? So the best one is, okay, place a conflict on a shared conflict list and ensure it is visible. Now you won't see these kind of, you know, theory. I have not learned this theory in the whatever theory lessons we have gone through. So this is slightly surprising where the question have come from. These are out of syllabus question. Sort conflict into two groups, positive and negative. Probably sort conflict into two categories, structural and interpersonal. I don't know what is that. Again, kind of not there in the theory. Review conflicts during daily scrum so that they are handled in a timely manner. Now, out of these, this is not recommended. We do not handle conflict in daily scrum. We do not put it on a shared conflict list. I don't think that's a term. So out of these two, this is something which I think is right. Also, PMI is not helping me to come to a conclusion because this question is out of the scenario question and not part of the PM bound, not part of any theory. So let me click on this and click, you know, see how am I doing. Let's look at the second one here, using reason and logic in discussion and communicating facts and ideas in a non-confrontation style is an indication of consciousness, openness, agreeableness, opinion. I don't know what is that. Again, out of syllabus question, I'm just gonna click on A and say confirm. Now these are the two questions. And again, these are not from the syllabus. PMI, what are you doing? So I'm not happy with this. I say, okay, I think the first one was correct and that's why you didn't. A project manager is assigned to an existing project, replacing the previous project manager, blah, blah, blah. And a lot of enthusiasm, reviews. They previously performed well together. What should do to address? KPIs are decreasing, okay. Meet with the sponsor. No, you don't. Work on identifying other resources. No, we don't. Meet with project team to discuss the current level of performance. Probably meet with the functional manager. So C looks the best of the answers. And that too, again, this is not from whatever study we have done. This is from my own personal opinion. And, you know, I'm just going to click on confirm. Apparently, this is a correct answer. So I didn't see the first answer was that correct or not. So when I click on confirm, it didn't show me the answer. I don't know why. Okay. So that was pretty much it. I got four questions to do the practice and out of four questions, I got, I think, one right. Not my fault, PMI. I don't know what are you doing. So far I'm okay with this. I'm not very happy with at least the topic called how do I manage conflicts. And here is the survey. So I can, what is this link? Where does it takes me? It takes me to surveymonkey.com. Okay. So basically it takes me to a SurveyMonkey to see, you know, how are people doing this stuff. I'm not too sure whether PMI has got it reviewed from the expert or not, because if some expert would have reviewed it, I would not see such kind of gaps in the study hall. So let me come back to the study plan and just to see how other things are. Let's look at this. Empower team members and stakeholders. The five stages of team development, a case study. So this is forming, storming, norming, and performing and adjoining. This is some theory here. And yeah, pretty much theory. I go back. And then, okay, there is the video here. Let's see what does the video says.
Both in my current role and my previous role, I have worked for software companies that provide software as a service, though in various fields from healthcare software to e-commerce related software. With this, the projects that I typically manage are usually implementations of our software with various customers, but I also manage people to do. The problem was, no one knew what they needed to do or when or what was most urgent. So when they had more bandwidth to be able to help out and do more work, they always had to go to the project manager to ask, what can I do to help? This made it so the project manager was spending a lot of time making decisions and was constantly having to divide up work anytime a team member had bandwidth. So it became more than a full-time job for them to make sure that the work was getting done and that people had enough work to do. And the problem here was not the team wasn't motivated, because they were. Everyone wanted the project to be successful.
I like this. This is a good video. Talks about, you know, how do people feel and How should you give the, manage resources within your project? So this is pretty good. Let's look at what is happening next. So this is some project fundas. So this is some cartoon and talks about some humor, which is pretty nice. Let's look at, I say continue. The parachute mind and group decision making techniques. Okay, study, study, and study. I think this is something nice. One can study here, and active listening, emotional intelligence. Oh, okay, everything is here. I say I like it. Continue. How do we make decision? We do dot voting. This is how do we make decision, which is nice. Okay, there are other decision methods which can be used. So okay, let me go forward. Okay, that's it. So this is the lesson which talks about managing conflict, which we have seen, build and lead a team, we have seen. This is the one which we were talking about. Okay, so I like it. It's not bad, it's not good, but it's very elaborative, and there is no questions here to test my knowledge. So I would rather like PMI to have, some lessons and then questions, the way they have some scenarios here. Okay, so this is the learning plan wherein you get some videos, some cartoons, and some theory which are put together for you, and that's how you learn. And so now I'm just gonna walk you through what is PMI teaching us: ground rules, team performance, EQ. I saw few of the ideas of EQ here as well. So EQ is moving around, then team ground rules. Shared understanding, business value. Okay, now what you see is process written here and people written here. This is a good way to identify, which domain are we moving. So people domain is taken care of the first, and then we are moving towards processes like manage communication, risk management, cost, schedule, deliverables, which is integration, and scope. So so processes, changes, procurement, artifact, process on methodology, and governance structure. Okay, let me see what is there in the business environment. In the business environment, we have compliances, and project benefits, and the external environment, which is nice. Organization change, meetings in the business environment, not too sure. Okay, so this is what you see in the learning plan. Let me walk you through the game center. Now there are different games which are there. Let's see each game and explore it. Let's see the flashcard. So there are few things which you can pick up and then start playing the game. So this is information radiator. I click on this. So there are, I don't know, what is brainstorming? So you need to select the one which is there. What is project charter? Oh, then I have to select the one which is, there are no instructions written, and that's why I'm confused as to what is that which I need to do. What is project charter? I think this is the See, I got it right now. What is Kanban board? Okay, there you get it. So, what is meeting management? And then here, yeah, apparently I'm doing good. So I go back to stakeholders and leaderboard. This is Card Hunter. So let me start Card Hunter. What is it? No instructions, as again, I don't know what I need to do. Project manager's ability to recognize, motivate team members, the process of risk, the written story. Okay, so I think this and this, yeah. So you have to match grooming, scope creep, project management plan, well, story. Okay, so I'm just gonna click with grooming. See, I know. So this is matching question, as the name suggests. You need to, PMI, you need to give some kind of instructions to people. Let's see Card Hunter 2 and see how is it. Again, I think we need to select two cards which are matching. The action points, contingency. Yeah, so you got it. You can also see these cards from here, card coupler. So let's see what is card coupler. So what is project charter? This and this. I don't know how do I click on play. Okay. Average amount of work, meeting, scrum, lot many things on the screen. And oh, I need to read this and then couple it with the other one. Oh my God. This is very difficult. I can't do it. I'm not playing a kids game. It's not, you see two matching apple and oranges. PMI, you cannot use this here. Card coupler is an out game. So much of theory, I can't remember which card has what. So this is not good at all from my perspective. Let's look at card sweeper. Start, and what does it say? Again, there are no instructions. What is it? The process group in which the project idea is examined and its feasibility is determined. Initiating, let's see if there is initiating here. I don't know. What is that which I need to do? Okay, restart. I think I need to select two right answers. Risk management technique, step to ensure, average amount of work. Okay, these two look good. Yeah, so you have to select the two cards which are kind of similar. So again, not very nice. Sudden death. Okay, let's start with this. This is the questions and answer during a meeting, blah blah blah. I just click on something and I click on okay. So these are the questions which you can do, and that's pretty much it. One question, how do I go back? I restart. Huh. Okay. There's just okay. These are many questions, so if I get them right, I think I go to the next question. A project manager is helping organization transition from utilizing predictive methods to agile. One of the project team member ask when hiring requirement definition and solution activities, when should it be done? In agile, these activities must start as soon as as soon as the project team is assembled, preferably in the sprint one. Sprint zero, avoid waste, done as part of development. In agile, team follows the last responsible movement strategy. Oh, I don't know because you have not taught me about this. So I will click on this and see what is that which is. So B is the one which you can select. Agile doesn't prescribe. See, I worked on agile project and there are different methodologies. I don't know where have you taken it from. So if I click on this, and let's see if it talks about sprint zero or sprint one. Each project is different, and each project has a different methodology to talk about. Let's see if there is something called sprint zero. There's nothing like that. So I'm again gonna say this is out of the syllabus question. So I'm restarting again, hoping that I get a good question. A project manager is leading a remote home office implementation. The project manager is surprised with early sign of resistance from key stakeholder in the organization. The stakeholders strongly disagree with the change, would require more persuasion than the project manager originally expected. Which two tools and techniques should be used to identify organizational and project influence of the stakeholder? Okay, I would write stakeholder analysis is the one. Stakeholder mapping could be another one. I really don't know because I don't know what is engagement map. So let's see. Okay, the first one is stakeholder metrics, and the second one is stakeholder map. So I was right about the tools, okay? If I talk about stakeholder metrics, it's not a tool and technique, it's the outcome. So technically, this answer is wrong. However, I would not argue with PMI. The question itself is wrong. The techniques are stakeholder analysis and stakeholder mapping. In fact, I would call, there is another called stakeholder engagement mapping, you know, wherein current and desired stakeholders are identified. Their current engagement level is listed and desired level is listed. I would be really unhappy to see my students struggling with these kind of questions and answers. Apologies, people, you are getting bad questions. Let's look at the crossword now. What is it? So these are the crosswords which are put up. If you have time, can you take a printout of this? Because I don't think I would have so much of time doing crosswords with this. So you can start writing what are things. One across, also known as predictive, it's project management approach that follows a sequential design and development process. PREDICTIVE. Okay, no. Reveal current letter. Waterfall. WATERFALL. Okay, great. A list of meeting topic activities in order to be addressed. Ideally, this agenda. AGENDA. Oh, we got it right. So this is how you can go ahead and test your knowledge. This is pretty okay, not that bad. If you have a lot of time, you can go ahead and do this. However, from the PMP exam perspective, I must tell you these are recallability questions. They're not going to help you in the PMP exam at all. So we have reviewed the game center. I have looked at each of them and then I've given my opinion. Let's look at the lessons now. It's the same as learning plan and the similar lessons which we have gone through. Flashcards are the flashcards which you can see and remember. So go to next, you can see and remember. If you want to, you can look at the list of the flashcard and see all of them together. This is something which is again recallability, and you might want to go through it. Not that bad, pretty okay. Practice test is something which I'm more interested in with PMI, and I've done few practice tests. Apparently, I have not got good answers. So this is the practice test which I've gone through called Manage Conflict. I would want you guys to review it with me and see, you know, what is the right answer. So this is the question, and whenever there are conflict, we meet. So this was pretty okay to talk. Now, structural and interpersonal. Nobody tells you that. There is nothing in the PMI's conflict management theories. It was out of syllabus question and I didn't like it. I don't know where is the structure and personal categories have come up from. So again, PMI, if you are listening, please ensure that this is part of the you know, the study material, or there has to be some kind of reference material from where you give the questions. This is the third one, again, out of context. What is the discussion and communicating facts, non-confrontational style, what is it? And if I go to the leadership framework, I would want to see, you know, whether the questions are from here. People, process, disciplined worker, extroversion. I don't know from where these terms have come from. These are not part of ECO, these are not part of PMBOK, and these are not part of, these should not be part of the PMP exam itself. So PMI, if you are listening, please do not refer to something just like that and make people, you know, go ahead and question their knowledge itself. So I'll come back. Let's look at the practice exam now. There are two full-length practice exams which are here. Let me click on this. Multiple choice, start practice exam, and let's see, start. So these are the questions. I click on something, confirm, click on something and confirm. There is this total time which is starting, and there is this section. So it is in one section, unlike the PMP exam which has three sections. I was expecting PMI should be able to demonstrate the way they do questions in the PMP exam itself. So three sections having 60 questions would have been a good example or simulation of the actual PMP exam. So these are the questions. You can flag or revisit later, and I'll do these questions and then come back to you. So these are few batches which are unlocked. It doesn't help me at all. I don't know why there are so many batches which are there. So I've done this. Let me go back to the study hall. I don't know how can I go to study hall, return to test. Okay. So I go for coffee. I don't know what is it. I go back and leave page. So apparently leaving the test is very difficult. So these are the practice exam. You have two full length exams and there are mini exams. As I said earlier, I did not like the exam. Look at how many questions are wrong. And I'm the reviewer of PMBOK 6. So many questions which are wrong. I've been reading a lot of books. However, most of the questions are either incorrect or taken from weird references. And then there's launch question of the day. And oh, I can't do that unless I have gone through the first section, which is understanding what is PMP and so on. So there you go. This is the PMI study hall. I wanted to keep it short, but keeping it short would not have given you the right perspective. So let me know how you feel about it. Let me know what are your views, and I would be really looking forward to hear back or your comments. Thank you so much. My name is Kavita Sharma and I'm the author of Pass PMP in 21 Days, a very concise, nice practice guides or books to read, do a lot of questions and pass the PMP exam within 21 days. Thank you. Have a very nice day. Bye-bye.